ASEPs are atmosphere surface exchangeable pollutants, and they travel through the atmosphere, but in between traveling through the atmosphere, they are deposited to and emitted from surfaces like water and tree canopies and even buildings.
The first fish advisories came out in the 70s, right? I was born in the 80s, but I never even really paid attention to them until I started working here. Mm-hmm. And now it's just a part of life, like understanding that the fish are toxic. You know, when you're proud of who you are, you're proud of your culture, you're proud of the foods that you eat, and then you have to withhold that stuff from your babies. That really hurts.
The big priorities that came out of our first workshop together really centered on having safe fish. Another priority that came up was the understanding these ASEPs, that they're extremely persistent and they're going to be around for many decades across generations, and within the community they were also looking for a long-term solution.
One of the first hints that there might be a problem here was when on Isle Royale in the early 70s, a researcher discovered some PCBs in a water body on Isle Royale, and they realized it was coming from the atmosphere. That leads to them constructing this monitoring network called the Integrated Atmospheric Deposition Network. And so this is one of the stations is up by Eagle River. And the purpose of that was to monitor the deposition and the atmospheric concentrations of these compounds. And the amount going from the atmosphere into the lake of PCBs and mercury was an order of magnitude or two greater than the amount coming in from streams and the soils.
So a local community doesn't have the ability to control what's coming from long distances away, and so most communities focus on what's within their power. And right, the hope was back in the 1970s, when we first became aware of the problem, that cleaning up those local sources would solve the problem locally and regionally. But time has gone on and the problem still exists.
And if the lake is sick, all of us who live around the lake, who do our recreation on the lake and exist off the lake, that means we're all sick.
We share the fate. And all our connections with the natural world around us, we share their fate.
And so we're realizing more and more the importance of international governance in controlling this problem. I mean, we might hope for quick solutions to problems because our children, our communities are being affected by these problems now. But the reality is that the solutions often take decades to generations or longer. And yeah, it's a sobering fact.